up, y'all? This is Menace with True Juggalo Family. I'm sitting here with the homie, DJ Clay.
What up?
We're approaching Mr. DJ Clay's 10th Hallowicked coming up.
My 10th annual? Uh-oh.
10 years with Psychopathic coming up in what, February?
February of 2016 will be my 10-year anniversary in the Psychopathic ever since Fuck the Fuck Off Insta tour with Shay Tito. Fucking brother. There and I'm pretty geeked up. I'm pretty excited about this Hallowicked because this is my first solo set at Hallowicked, and man, I got some shit in store for y'all. So, and on top of it, it's my 10th Hallowicked, so this shit is it came at a better time, I think. Like, it's like as if it was meant to happen, you know what I'm saying? So, I'm pretty excited about it, and I will not let down. You guys are gonna go crazy. I don't want to tire everybody out before the rest of the act, but that's what I'm here for, right? That's what I'm supposed to do. That's my job. I'm a DJ. Turn up time. Make sure you got your drinks when I'm at the on stage.
Yeah, that's what's up. Well, let me go ahead and get on to the notes, like Jay and Shags would say. What are some artists outside of Psychopathic that you'd like to work with?
Outside of Psychopathic? I'd really like to work with... I'd like to work with G-Eazy, actually.
That's what's up.
I've been listening to him lately, his last record. And I was pretty fucking impressed. Actually, I somehow was slept on him, and I was put up on him by a homie, and that's where I was banging, and I was just like, you know, how the fuck did I miss this? You know what I'm saying? I'm a DJ, I'm usually on everything, I'm top of everything, you know? But I've been banging GED a lot lately, so outside of Psychopathic, I would like to work with GED, you know what I'm saying? And I'd also like to work with a couple of DJs, you know? I've talked to DJ Hoppa, he's on Volume, and Bobby D, you know, we probably will be working together. Purely speculation.
So maybe a possibility of like a DJ spinoff or something?
Mm-hmm. Maybe, or just a full out DJ tour. It's all in talks, not set in stone. Like I said, it's in talks, you know? But those are the chances that I would like to work outside of Patrick right now. You know what I'm saying? It's like off the top of my head right now, you know what I'm saying?
It's fucking fresh, man. I fucking hope we see that, man. Now, let's see. What would you say? I mean, with Halloween approaching and Devil's Night here in Detroit.
Devil's Night in Detroit. We gonna set some fires.
Hell yeah. What would you say is your favorite horror movie?
My favorite horror movie? Sex in the City. And Sex in the City 2. They both get shit out of me. Every Halloween I throw them on. And, I make my pets dress up like them chicks.
It's the and nose, right?
Yeah, it's uncanny how my dog and cat just like them when you put the right wigs on them. So that's pretty fucking creepy and creeps me out. So I would say those are my favorite. Not favorite horror movies, but those are the ones I'm the most scared of. So.
Fresh. Well, but with this being the 10th anniversary for you at Hallowicked, what are some of your most freshest fucking memories?
Ooh,
at Hallowicked.
My precious Hallowicked memory?
Mm-hmm.
Man, there ain't one that I can point out that's fresher than the other. I mean, every Hallowicked has its own special magic to it. You know, it's like, I'd be able to answer this question a lot better after tomorrow night.
Nice.
You know what I'm saying? Nice. Because I'm really planning on tomorrow night to be one of my best memories. But aside from what's been going on tomorrow night at Hallowicked, my best memory is the first Hallowicked that I've ever done, 2006. You know, I never thought that after that tour, I would be touring with ICP for the next 8 years after that, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, it's crazy, you know? And so aside from the first, I'm about to make a new great memory tomorrow, you know what I mean?
Hey, it's definitely gonna be something worth remembering, that's for sure.
Oh yeah, I got some monstrous shit lined up, you know what I'm saying? Put it this way, it's Philosodonus meets ICP meets your favorite fucking genre. It's like I'm a chameleon, I'll morph into the fucking sound you want to hear. And you'll have, you know, there's something I got that will move everybody in that crowd. There's nothing I have on my playlist that will have somebody standing still. You know, I've been practicing mad hard. If you tuned in last night, I'm Periscope. You've seen the little quick behind the scenes rehearsal and all that, but
know, I got a lot of cool shit in store. And it's gonna be, just have your cups up and get ready to turn the fuck up, because it's like, it's going down tomorrow night, you know. A whole other way. DJ Clay, the way you've never seen me before.
Oh yeah, it's gonna be fucking exciting as hell, man. Now, if you had three people that you could bring back from the dead to rock out with, who would it be?
If I could bring them back from the dead, my number one would be Michael Jackson. I'd bring him back from the dead. And if I had an opportunity to work with him, obviously, yeah, I would definitely do that. I'd ask him to teach me the moonwalk. You know, I'm not that bad at moonwalking as it is. I would show you right now, but I want to, you know.
Y'all ain't ready for that.
You ain't ready for that. I don't want her people's skills, I'm good at it, you know. But Michael Jackson, I'd probably bring back, you know, I almost said Kurt Cobain, but no, he's cool where he's at. And I would bring back Cliff from Metallica and work with him. That's what I would bring back, you know what I'm saying? I know that people are like, whoa, some of you guys are probably like, who the fuck is that? Well, do your homework, goddammit, and you'll see.
Fucking legend.
Yes, exactly. And a third? I would bring back, I'd bring the Backstreet Boys back from the dead, just so they can do, you know, everybody, you know, they can't help it, but I'd bring them back from the dead, they're not dead.
Their careers might be well.
Tomato, tomato. Hey, agree to disagree, right? So that's about it.
Fresh. Well, this next question I'm asking on behalf of TJF's own camera ninja,
okay.
Kim out of Dallas. This
one's
for you.
Dallas, this is your question.
She wants to know, boxers or briefs?
Oh, she wants to know boxers or briefs. Well, I got a better answer for you. Commando all day.
There you go, camera ninja. I told you I got you on that.
Yeah, I let my dick hang in my jeans. I'm sorry. Or maybe I'm not sorry. No, I'm not sorry. But sorry for you dudes that are watching right now, like, that's gay. Well, it's not. So what I like being commando. They draws and boxers that are fucking comfortable enough for me.
I don't even know what to say.
It's the truth.
Well, let me ask you. I mean, this is a question not everybody may really give a fuck about, but, you know, being a DJ, you know, it'd be interesting to know what your perspective on it is. What do you think about Paris Hilton DJ?
Paris Hilton DJ? I think, first off, today's DJ is a different type of DJ. I was lucky enough to be born into a world where I was still fucking with vinyls and shit.
Fuck yeah.
I'm saying, like, I'm talking straight.
That almost seems like it's dead.
Yeah, I was like a little 13-year-old kid pulling records out of fucking out of crates, you know what I'm saying? Like, straight up. Not Serato, not none of that. Not knocking none of that right now, because I need that now. But, you know, I was straight out the crates and stuff like that. So my opinion on her is, I know that she couldn't hold a candle to the DJs that can do that, that can pull that off still, the old school flavor. She couldn't hold a candle to that. But yeah, put her behind some cool samplers and some fresh digital shit, laptop, you know, and she, anybody's a good DJ after that. But the thing about her is, she's famous as fuck. So, why not, right? I mean, she's famous. She gets paid, what, fucking $40,000 to show up at a club? So why not get paid extra fucking $40,000 to fucking DJ as well? You know what I'm saying? So it's like, it's all business and politics. I mean, she's a joke, but at the same time, she's out there getting her money, and you know, I gotta respect that. You know, anybody that's doing their own business and getting money, but the thing is, she didn't come up from the roots of DJing and shit like that. You know, I felt like somebody sat down and showed her how to work a laptop. You know? And,
yeah.
But other than that, I mean, I ain't got a problem with it. Let her do her thing, you know what I'm saying? Hey, that's cool, you know what I'm saying?
Would you rock out a set with her?
Yeah, I'd rock out a set with her. You know, I think she pulls like fucking 40,000 people. Yeah. And then I would just show those 40,000 people how you really do it. You know what I'm saying? And make her look bad. So, yeah, fuck yeah.
Hell yeah, that's dope.
And then I'd try to hit it. That'd be like...
DJ Clay Six Tape.
I wouldn't want to get paid.
Well, what do you think about what's your opinion on the state of hip-hop these days?
The state of hip-hop right now is fresh, man. There's so much shit. It's like, and you don't just label it to, like, the hip-hop genre, you know what I'm saying? Like, the hardcore hip-hop, you know what I'm saying? It's like, just hip hop, rap, you know what I'm saying? Just the you know, just the music scene in general, aside from the rock scene, you know what I'm saying? EDM, all that stuff, it's just all so integrated right now. You know what I'm saying? You see people getting on trap beats and dubstep beats, and or at least mixing it, you know what I'm saying? Kanye West and Jay-Z mixing it in their records and shit like that, you know what I'm saying? Mainstream artists do. Everybody doing it now, so I think hip hop's in a good state right now, as far as like, well, especially the DJs. Like, DJs are popular as hell right now.
Yeah.
I know a lot of club owners and promoters that would rather bring out a DJ than a band. And so, in fact, it's a lot easier to work with, and a DJ can bring as much people as a band as with less headache, you know what I'm saying? So, but yeah, music, hip hop, it's in a good state right now, man. I mean, there's a lot of that, I don't know, what I would call that stupid rap, but at the same time, it ain't stupid because
it's selling.
Because not just because it's selling, but it's like the beats are fucking banging. Like, you know, I really haven't bought a record lately to where the production is just shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, all these producers out here these days, they're just killing the game. You know what I'm saying? Like, producers are getting better and better and better. You know what I'm saying? So, and the producers are really shining and helping the hip hop game out. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, I think the hip hop game, music game, rap game, I think, is fucking sweet right now. You know what I'm saying? We're in a good state right now.
Well, just to variate on that a little bit, you know, just kind of going off the fly from the note, which do you think is more of a force to be reckoned with? You know, like the stuff that you hear on the radio, or more of like the independent grind of things?
I mean, obviously, if it's on the radio, it's getting crammed down your throat. So
right.
That's a force right there. Like, you know, you might not even like the song, but you'll catch yourself fucking singing it in your head because you just, you know, drove to work and drove to the studio and stuff. You know, yeah. So, but, you know, it's like, I think that, you know, it's cool to get a radio hit, you know, to get that push and the publicity and get some fame. But most people that put out a single, the rest of their record, dope, you know what I'm saying? If it's a gangster rapper, he puts out a soft ass song, and people are like, oh, fuck that guy, that shit sucks on the radio. But why don't you give the rest of the record a chance, you know what I'm saying? Why don't you give the rest of the album a chance, and then you'll see. Because that's kind of more the underground side of it, because not everybody just has, you know, an album full of singles, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, the radio only plays fucking whack shit, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, if you hear someone and you think you like them, go check out their record, because the record's probably doper than the single that's on the fucking radio, you know what I'm saying? That's all bullshit anyway, you know? Radio, you know what I'm saying? Until y'all motherfuckers start playing me, I'm gonna fuck about the radio.
Well, let me ask you, like, you've toured all over the fucking place. What are the rowdiest spots that you've been to?
Ooh. Starting from Northwest, all the way down the West Coast, down the Southwest, in Texas, down South Florida, that whole, they're all rowdy. The New Mexico really stands out, and Texas stands out.
Hell yeah.
Dallas stands out, you know what I'm saying? Dallas stands out. Yeah, hey. But Dallas really stands out. I mean, there's never been a time I came to Dallas and it wasn't rowdy as fuck, you know? And New Mexico, it's like, I've answered this question a couple times before, and it's like the same answer. There it is, a whole other level of New Mexico craziness. The first time that I ever walked out on stage and heard chicks screaming like it was a Justin Bieber concert or something, you know what I'm saying? Like, it was like, that's the only place that happens to New Mexico. And I got a lot of love for New Mexico, you know?
Well, now, I gotta ask, Naptown Mike, he from PGF, he wants to know, will we ever see another Mario Kart Monday again?
Mario Kart Monday. Funny you ask. I can't believe like that's still being talked about. It's been like 4 years or something since I did the last Mario Kart Monday. I started out Mortal Kombat Monday not too long ago, and I ended up getting real busy, so I couldn't really commit to it. You know what I'm saying? But if you're watching this and you really want to get down to Mario Kart Monday, leave some comments on my Twitter, my Instagram, my Facebook, anything. And if there's enough, I'll start it back up. Just for y'all. I'll start it.
All right, so like you got some upcoming projects coming up, I'm sure, man. You got this drip vape line coming out. Tell us a little bit about what you got going on, man.
Well, I do got my own e-liquid line. It's my own company. It's called Drip. You know what I'm saying? It's not just DJ Clay. You know what I'm saying? We are expanding to other artists that are interested, to other celebrity line celebrities that are interested. So that way it's expanding real fast too. Like, it's overwhelming. You know what I'm saying? Like, I really didn't expect it to take off the way it did. So I'm real humbled by that. You know, and it's just like it's taking off right now. It's like the flavors are great. I've been going to like vape shops and doing vape shop stop. They're kind of like, they're basically like meet and greets. Oh, and I'm DJing a little bit. And I mingle with the people, feedback on my flavors and all that stuff, because right now at this stage, that's what I need. I need the feedback on flavors, you know? So, you know, it's for sale now. Definitely, come hit up the DJ Clay merch booth at Hallowicked tomorrow, all the fresh DJ Clay here, plus Drip will be there, you know what I'm saying? If you vape, will be there in 0.36% of nicotine, for those of you that like nicotine. We got four flavors. We got two more flavors right now that haven't dropped. And third one being talked about right now.
Literally, right now.
We're doing something for Sleep of the Mile when that comes up. But other than, Drip, then music-wise, I'm obviously touring a lot. I've been touring constantly, so set up for a tour around January, and then right after that tour, I'm gonna quit touring for a little bit, lock myself in the studio. I'm putting out a free mixtape on DatFip. I'm putting out another official DJ Clay mixtape in store. And for those of you that didn't ask it for years and years, yes, I am putting out my record, the solo DJ Clay record, this spring. So a lot of work to do for me, a lot of pressures for y'all. If you're a DJ Clay fan, then come your way all early next year.
Always grinding, man. In fact, you're on your way to an in-store vape.
I actually got to leave as soon as we're done here. Head out to Ohio and then back home to Detroit for Halloween tomorrow.
Yeah.
So much fun, man. I love y'all. Everybody that's watching, I love y'all straight up. Like, that's from my heart. You know, say much love to Trey. Much love to the whole True Devil fan. Much love to all the sites out there that show me love. Scotty. Fagel lovers, you know what I'm saying? Juggalo News, everybody. Much love to everybody that's always showing me support, you know what I'm saying? Since day one, you know what I'm saying? Mainly it's been y'all, you know what I'm saying? As far as media, y'all have been showing me a lot of love since day one.
You know what that's what's up, man. Well, where can everybody find you if you don't already know? You should if you don't.
Oh, shit. Everything is just under my name, basically. Instagram, DJClay313. Twitter, DJClay313. Facebook, DJClayOfficial. DJClay.com, all that stuff. It's just my name.
Yeah. Well, if you didn't know, now you know.
Yeah. And if you don't follow, now you're gonna go follow.
That's right.
Right.
That's right.
Right.
Well, this is Minutes with True Juggalo Family signing off. Hope to see y'all motherfuckers at Hallowicked tomorrow. It's gonna be fucking fresh as fuck. I heard the set last night. Oh my god, you're gonna fucking love it. I'll see you there. Whoop whoop.